Hi friends, a happy morning to each one of you. Today I want to share a real life experience of a 14-year-old girl named Meena. Meena was from a well-to-do family, an easygoing person. One day as she went to school and as she entered her class, she was shocked to see her friend doing her math homework, as she had completely forgotten about it. She managed to complete her homework during her science class. Unfortunately, she was caught. She felt sorry about it. Some of her friends laughed at her, calling her moti. She was hurt and angry at this, as this had become a regular way to have fun for them. During the PE class, while playing badminton, she was enraged by certain comments passed at her. She couldn't stop herself and gave one on the boy's head with the racket. He was hurt, taken to the doctor and attended. Dear friends, what consequences do you think Meena must have faced? What could have brought her to behave this way? Have you faced similar situations when your emotions run so high that you are unable to hold on and tend to react impulsively? At home these days, to whom do you generally react aggressively? Think of an incident when you last found yourself behaving in a way for which you regretted later. Most of the time, don't we hold other people responsible for our hurt, irritation and anger? Yes, people may behave in a way they want to. There are certain behaviors which are acceptable and certain which are not. How can we deal with those which are not acceptable to us? We all feel angry, irritated, jealous, embarrassed, frustrated, hurt, etc., which is absolutely normal. Instead of controlling and suppressing it, wouldn't it be better if we learn how to manage with our emotions? What will happen if something is suppressed and controlled for a long time? I understand managing our emotions can be really tough at times. It can test our patience and limits. Would you want to exercise your emotions managing muscles and keep yourself strong? Any ideas how we can go about it? Who's your role model? Whom do you want to be like? Would you want to research and absorb their skills? There are many techniques to manage emotions. One is empathy, where we put ourselves in others' shoes and try to understand what they may be going through or what could have brought them to behave in a certain way. Visualization is another powerful technique where we visualize ourselves in a situation in our minds and imagine how best we can handle it in a way that is appropriate to us. Dear friends, all our emotions have a powerful role to play in our lives. Each emotion comes with a message. Let us be cautious about how we interpret it, add meaning to it, accept it, and express it. Thank you so much for listening. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.